سمعة الفكر تناجي الله في صبر وترجو رحمة تسري فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters and dear friends, hope you guys are doing well. Welcome to this video. Obviously, before I start, I want to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, the most just. All praises, glory, and gratitude belong to Him. My voice might sound a little bit different because I'm a bit ill. But obviously, as you guys know, this topic is a very serious topic, and it's a matter that I really wanted to do for such a long time. But qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah, destined it that I do it with this amazing brother, you know, because I've been meaning to do it for a long time, but it's been postponed, etc., etc. And subhanAllah, you know, somebody told me about you, and I thought, this is the guy I'm supposed to do this with. Do you get it? So alhamdulillah, yeah, but we're going to come to your story later. But obviously, as we know, with the matters of divorced sisters and how they're treated in the society, like I feel ashamed to use this word. Wallahi, I really feel ashamed to use this word, but they are treated like prostitutes. Like there's something filthy, disgusting. Like when you say, oh you're a divorcee, it's like, okay, I might marry you as a second, or you know, I might want to do this. And I genuinely know there's brothers out there who do it for genuine reasons, but I'm talking about those individuals who look down on divorced sisters. And not only divorced sisters who, you know, get divorced without, like, you know, things don't work out, which is normal, but also the sisters who are divorced and they have a child, which is even worse. Now they're like, oh, you know, that excess baggage, etc. And it's so sad, wallahi, because when we look at the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, majority of his wives were divorcees or widows, you know. And at the time of the messenger, the Sahaba would, you know, they would race with each other to marry somebody. Because at the end of the day, not only, like, I personally believe, like, some people in this society think, oh, you're doing that sister a favor. No, wallahi, she's doing you a favor. The fact that you're going to marry her and be a father figure for a child, it's not hard. I mean, it's not easy. It's hard, like, it's something, it's hard. It's not every man's job to do that. Do you get what I'm trying to say? It takes a real man to do that, no. You know? It's not easy. It's easy for you to say, oh, I'll do this, I'll do that. Wallahi, the sister is a blessing upon you. That the fact that you're going to look after her, especially in this society when this cultural thing, I personally, like, for the sake of Allah, I hate it. This cultural thing. This, oh, she's this colour, she's not from my caste, she's not from my tribe. Wallahi, you disgust me, Aki. I'm being honest, yeah? Like, when I mean culture, I'm not talking about your cultural things. That's karma. You know, I like, you know, biryani and all this kind of stuff. That side of your culture, nobody's got a problem with. But the fact that they look down on divorced sisters, wallahi, it really upsets me. And like I said, Aki, it's a video that I'm really passionate about. Yeah. And it's so sad. And like I said before, Aki, the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet, peace be upon him, they would die, you know, like to marry somebody that's divorced. They had nothing, no issues like that. But in today's society, you know, if we go to people and be like, oh, like, you know, what do you love about the Sunnah or the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him? A lot of people say, you know, I like this, I like that, blah, 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 this, that. But they would never, ever say, okay, you know, like, if we was to go and ask them, you know, would you marry a divorcee? A lot of brothers out there, they want to. And I hear the stories a lot. They want to, but they say, oh, but when I tell my family, what? You're going to marry a divorcee? You know, can't you do something better? And it's so sad, wallahi, Aki. And the reason why I said that, it's a perfect timing that you're here and you're doing this. And obviously, you guys might recognize a brother from a video from Digital Member.
No.
Yeah, which you can see on the screen, as you can see. But you can watch that later on. There's going to be a link at the end, inshallah. And you must watch it because, alhamdulillah, when I first watched it, it really affected me and changed me for the better in certain ways, subhanAllah. So you can watch that video afterwards, but stick to this firstly. So, Brother Eamon, may Allah bless you firstly. Wallahi, I've been, like, wanting to meet you for a long time. So, like, the qadr of Allah. Yeah, to be honest, Aki, like, what we're going to do with Brother Eamon is we're going to go through, because obviously Brother Eamon is married to a divorced sister. May Allah subhanAllah grant her Jannah. May Allah reward you, Aki, for what you're doing. You know, like I said, like not that there's anything wrong to do, but in today's society, because they've made it such a thing. So Aki, like, how did it happen? Like, right, like obviously I don't want it to be like, okay, how did you meet her, etc. But, you know, what is the pros and the cons? Like, obviously, I'm sure you don't, but, like, you know, do you regret it? Do you think, you give me that bit of feedback.
Okay. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Salatu wasalam ala nabina wa maulana Muhammad wa ala alihi ashabi ajma'in. Fama ba'd. The number one thing I'm going to start off by saying, which you said, which is a blessing Because you need to understand, yeah, that divorcee, that sister, has already been in a marriage. She knows the good things and the bad things, the positive and the negative things. So for her to still choose you after she's been through a negative marriage, that means a lot. That says everything itself, you understand? Mm-hmm. So at the end of the day, you know, for her to know, for her to be, like most sisters nowadays get forced into marriage. Yes. And this is a major thing. Yeah. They get culture mixed up with the deen, and that's a... also yeah, a major yeah. sin.
That's culture.
Culture, nothing to do with Islam. Yeah. So at the end of the day, it's a blessing that the sister, one, you know, she's much older than me. You know, she's 27, alhamdulillah. She got a beautiful child, you know, and she's got a beautiful soul. And I'm grateful that she accepted me out of every single person in the dunya to accept me to be that father figure, like you said, for her child. Yeah. Like, I've already explained to her that I can't be the child's father, but yeah. I'm going to try my best to be the best person I can be towards him. Yeah, you understand what I'm saying? So, alhamdulillah, the positive things are basically she completes your deen. This is something that people are forgetting. Not your mother, not your father. Your mother is the gates to Jannah, yeah. but she doesn't complete your deen. Yeah. Your father, your siblings and your family, none of these people complete your deen. That's what people need to understand. And I've lost a lot of people regarding this issue, to be honest. And some people are close to me, some people...
why did you lose them? What was the reason?
Because at the end of the day, the iman was at a level where I've passed so long ago. Mm. They were asking me questions like, why are you with an older person?
Like, and she's older than you?
Yeah.
Okay, mashallah.
Yeah, no, she's 27. I'm 22 years old.
Mashallah.
And, jazakallah. But, like, what can I say is they were like, how can you be with a sister that's divorced?
So, number one, divorced.
One, number one is divorced. Yeah. Number one is the age. Number two is her color skin. Mashallah, she's a natural, you know, color of Arab, which is like brown skinned, golden skin. Yeah. This Arab, this color that we have now is just something that died down a very long time ago. But people mistake my color as the natural Arab, which is not true. Wallah al-Azim, you got sisters in the Arab country that pow their face. It's like they're sponsored by Super Drug and Boost, the amount of makeup they put on. You understand what I'm saying?
Funny, that's even sad because this is a pressurized thing. This color. Oh, I have to be this color because this is accepted. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Like, even those certain sisters we feel sorry for because your culture has made you think, okay, I have to be this color so I can fit in. And they like, it's sad. You see this, it's not. And we don't mean it in any way of mocking sisters in hijab. But it's sad. Like, you look at some sisters, like, obviously you should lower your gaze. But what I'm trying to say is their hands are, like, white. And then look at the faces, like, like different color. And it's sad because why? Because they think this is superior. I have to be pale. I have to be lighter skin.
No.
We should be proud of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created every single one of us in a unique way, and we should be proud of that.
Sorry, what I wanted to say, like you said, which is you know, the number one thing, yeah, is it's a blessing. Take, you know, you have to be grateful that a sister that's divorced, that's gone through a marriage, Allahu a'lam if it was good or bad, but she's experienced. Obviously, it turned out to be for the negative part of things because it ended up in her being divorced. Yeah. So, you know, it's a blessing that she's been in a marriage and she's chose me. Out of every single person in the dunya, chose me to be that father figure to her child. To chose me to spend the rest of her life with her. Most importantly, for me to complete her deen.
That's so beautiful. Like, I'm sorry, I'm cutting you, but you know what's so beautiful is the fact that you're saying she chose me. Because a lot of times be like, oh, I chose you. Like, I did a favor and you was divorced. And you're older than me, and I married you. But subhanAllah, like, I can see from you, like, it's not, this is not staged. Did I ask you to say this? You're saying to me, like, she chose me, which is so beautiful. Wallahi, this is something that it lacks.
Jazakallah, wallahi, this is exactly what it is. She chose me, and what you understand, she didn't, she chose me for who I am. I've had a bad past. I've been, you know, I've had ups and downs, and plus with the condition that I'm in now, you know, I've been stabbed. And I've got a colostomy bag, and this is something that's very severe to me. I've got nerve damage on the left side of my body. Like, does she really have to go with someone that's handicapped? Because I'm classed as a handicapped person, you know.
You're more strength than... When you shake my hand, I thought he was going to break it for a second. May Allah bless you.
But alhamdulillah, you know what I'm saying? It's the whole concept of, basically, brothers, the iman is really low. But at the end of the day, the sisters have a... You know, they've got a ton as well. You understand what I'm saying? They need to know how to use that.
Yeah.
And they need to really, really let their words penetrate your heart. You understand what I'm saying? And this is exactly what the sister did.
Yeah.
Before she before she accepted me, she wanted to know the real things about me. She really wanted to know me itself, you understand, my soul. And since I've been with the sister, I have 22 years of my life, I've never been this closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never in my life, wallah al-adhim. I used to pray, like you said, you know, you could do your basics, pray five times a day, do zakah there and then. But for me to be 100%, because there were certain sins in the society and the environment we live in. It's hard for us to leave certain sins behind, because you're so used to it. But wallahi, when she came along, she destroyed that.
You get lots of words. When I was watching the video, when I was watching, you're just like, my wife. And wallahi, it melted my heart when I would see that. Because even now, you just seem like you're lost for words. It's like, wallahi, may Allah reunite you guys in Jannah.
Ameen.
Wallahi, alhamdulillah. So how was your family, Aki? Obviously, you went ahead with the marriage, but what was the reaction of the family?
The number one thing that I had to mention to my family is that, one, I'm going to be living with this person. You're not going to be living with us. Yeah. And number two, which is most important, is this person is going to complete my deen. That's the most important thing. She's brought me closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even when she was abroad, wallah al-azim, she used to wake, even though it's a 4-hour difference where she's ahead of us, wallah al-azim, she used to wake me up for Fajr. This is a wife. This where do we find women like this in today's society?
The question is, because a lot of the time, what advice would you give to a brother? Obviously, look, we need to respect the parents. No. Yeah? And it's not like we're giving some fatwa here, but what would you give advice to that brother who's on that? Like, he wants to marry a sister that's divorced. Do you get what I'm trying to say? But the parents, or there's been issues being caused. Like, what advice would you give? Obviously, what would you say to them? Like, they're on that verge and they're like, my parents are causing this big issue. If I go ahead, what advice would you give them?
When my family didn't want nothing. My father, till this day now, to be honest, he still, I try my hardest to salam him.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to salam me back. But at the end of the day, I can't cut my ties with my father. Yeah, do you understand what I'm saying? I haven't picked my woman over my father. But at the end of the day, it's my woman that completes my deen, not my father. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. No, mashallah. And subhanAllah, sometimes I would, there is people that message our team regarding this. I'm a divorced sister, etc., etc. Like, when these communities and these backward-thinking individuals, when they look down at these sisters, I look at these sisters, I swear to God, Akia, I don't think there is not many brothers that they can do what they do. You're a mother and you're a father. You're looking after that child. You have to provide for that child. You have to work, clothe them, look after the house. Which one of you brothers, I'm just being honest, which one of you brothers can do that? It's hard, Akia. I know there's brothers out there who's lost their wife. It's hard upon them. Do you get what I'm trying to say?
No.
But seriously, when I look at these sisters who are divorced, I just see they're doing the real form of jihad. Before you guys got a mad one, struggling, striving. This is struggling, striving, Aki. And who are you with your little brain, backwarded, disgusting brain, looking at sisters who are divorced and, I'm doing a favor if I marry. Who do you think you are? She's doing you a favor.
No.
You know, it really saddens me, Aki. Wallahi, it really saddens me. And like I said, I see these sisters as soldiers. I'm being honest, Aki, man. I've seen it. In this time of society where it's sexualized, look, everyone has needs. These sisters are treated like they're some kind of disgusting being, and they still stand their ground, look after their child, be a mother and fatherly figure, and do everything for them. And then you have these backwarded individuals and brothers acting I'm doing something. Wallahi, you're not. And I salute these sisters. I'm just being honest, straight to the heart, and I'm not saying it for any reason. Wallahi, I salute you sisters who are out there struggling. And inshallah, may Allah give you guys patience, because it's not easy, because I really mean this, because these sisters out there, they struggle. You know, they strive really, really hard. And I've seen it, Aki. You get what I'm trying to say? Yeah. That's why when I see brothers like you, wallahi, Aki, I look up to people like you, because Aki, it's not easy. Do you get what I'm trying to say? But is there anything that you want to leave the viewers with? Both sisters who are divorced and brothers who... anything that you want to leave them with?
No.
Okay, finish off.
First of all, I want to say to the sisters, like the brother said, I salute you too. And what I want to say is, whatever you're doing, carry on doing it. Don't change anything about it. Do not change yourself for another man whatsoever. Let the man change himself for the sake of Allah, for you and for you only. Nothing else. And because we need to understand, for sisters nowadays to accept you for who you are and for your past says a lot about them. And for the sister, for my wife to accept me for who I am, and then sometimes she clothe me and bathe me and even change my colostomy bag. That
That's most sisters wouldn't do that. You understand what I'm saying? So sometimes they're like, oh, I'll keep myself away. Trust but me. For a divorcee sister to choose you over everything, then wallah al-azim, you shouldn't change a bit about yourself. Let the man accept you for who you are. And if he really loves you and he really thinks that you complete his deen, then he will fight for you. And for the brothers, I think you don't need to grow up. Like your imams, you need to work on your iman, you need to work on your dhikr, you need to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and every single thing you do. And you really just need to grow up. I'm 22 years old, but the you know, the relationship that I've had with my wife, because I've been married for 6 months now, alhamdulillah, the relationship I have with my wife now, is better than relationships that married couple have had for 10 years. Do you understand? So even though it's made me lose people out of my life, but at the end of the day, it's for the best. It's for the best. You get what I'm saying? So that's the only, you know, advice I can give you. And basically, I just want to, you know,
JazakAllah khairan for... It's like I said, it's a pleasure, Akim, man.
It's a pleasure. Yeah, come Imran. You see how we come to with that scooter? Woo!
No, yes,
sir. Make some room for the brother.
Come. A lot of people, they frown, obviously, upon it. What? Okay, come here.
A lot of jahil people.
Come here, quick.
No, it's okay. A lot of people, obviously, they it's okay. They don't know who I am, man. Okay. Basically, a lot of parents, they, you know, they frown upon it, but obviously it's a big, not gamble, but it's a big risk that you're taking. Not risk, but choice you're making. Do I like lose a lot of the respect, not a respect, but a lot of the relationship that I have with my parents, of a woman that I don't know yet, or do I stick with, like, you know, my principle that I don't mind marrying a divorced sister? Or like, what do you advise to those? Because there's a lot of brothers that want to do it because they like the idea of one, someone who's experienced, someone who's got children, and someone who's obviously a lot older as well.
To be honest, Aki, if my parents are telling me not to marry someone because of the sole reason, oh, she's a divorce, she has a child, I'm sorry. I love you. Mom, dad, I love you. Call me anytime. But if you're going to be like, oh, her color, or she's this, or she's that, Aki, I'm being honest, you need to stick around. My family had an issue, like, okay, you marrying somebody that wears the hijab, or this, that. They had an issue with Aki. Aki, I stuck to my ground. I said, look, mom, dad, I love you guys, but this is what I want. Today, they accepted it. They're okay with it. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So I think that's not a reason, Aki, like, to think. But I respect where you're coming from. Obviously, then it's your parents causing that commotion. It changes from person to person.
I just want to add some balance to what you said, though, before I said that, because I don't think it's as clear cut as that, though, Aki, because, obviously, you have, obviously, Islam is all about bringing the good and pushing away the evil, right?
Yeah.
Obviously, the good in this matter is to marry... To marry your sister to help her out, who's in a situation like that, right? And to push away the evil.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, said that the intelligent one is not the person who knows the good from the bad.
Mm.
It's the one who knows the better of the two goods and the lesser of the two bads. Okay. You see what I'm saying? So, although generally speaking, it is better, you're right, it is better to go find a sister in that situation, and your family might be causing an issue to speak to them, whatnot. But every situation has to be judged on its merits, because you have to look at, you bringing this person into your life, okay, if you bring this person into your life, then subhanAllah, you might actually end up losing 5-6 people, right? Now, if these are 5-6 any people, whatever. If it's like parents, then obviously it's a bigger situation, right? But then now, you know, but like I'm saying, every situation depends on its merits. Because now, for example, say there's a brother who's with a sister and he's doing zina with her. And the parents are telling you, no. Well, then the zina here is worse than upsetting your parents. So, I'm just saying, the reason, what I'm trying to say is, when you find yourself in a situation where your parents are opposing, go to an imam, because you did that, right?
Yes,
you went to the Sharia council, right?
I went to the Sharia council. I told them about my situation and everything. And actually, one thing I wanted to say,
they gave you the green light.
They gave me the green light. And, it was Islamic. It was 100% Islamic.
Because the ulama, they know better about our affairs. You know what I'm saying? Allah said, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. If you don't know, go ask the people who do know. So with these situations, I think it's always best to not make it like general. For you, man, to just start saying, brother, Ali said, I'll go get married and bun my mum. Brother, you mad?
Yeah.
Go to the sheikh. Yeah.